Hello students, my name is Iris France, 我叫林婉如. Today I'm going to talk about these 5 smart steps that will help you to succeed in your online classes. Now we know because of COVID-19, we have to transition our face-to-face classes into online classes. And I know it's a little bit intimidating for students who have never taken online classes. And that's the reason why I'm going to introduce these 5 smart steps that will help you to succeed. So the first thing you have to do is to read your updated syllabus. If the class is a game, then the syllabus states the rule of the game. If you want to win the game, you have to first read the syllabus. So I want you to read, not just skim the updated syllabus. Pay attention to the videos that professors have uploaded that you have to watch, or the new format of the assignment. Maybe now it's only online assignment, or maybe your final exam has been replaced by a term paper. You don't know until you read the syllabus. So that's the first thing you have to do. Second, manage your space and your time. So let's first talk about space. You must have a space that will help you to concentrate on your online classes. Preferably, it will be a desk, either in your home office or in your bedroom, so you're not disturbed by other things. And of course, you need to have a reliable computer and reliable internet. I don't think I need to elaborate that. And third, you want to have headsets, because that will help you to focus and concentrate on the online lectures. It will also help you not to disturb your family members, because I bet right now your parents are also stuck at home, working from home, and your siblings are also taking online classes. So you want to help yourself to concentrate and also not to disturb them. And also when you study, you can also consider earplugs. And you also want to manage your time. I know online classes, they don't feel like real classes, but they are. Therefore, you need to manage your time. Now that you don't have to get up early at 8 o'clock in order to go to your morning classes anymore, it is very tempting to cancel your alarm clock. Please don't do that. Keep your alarm clock on. Get up at the same time as before. If you want to sleep for extra half an hour, that's okay. But you want to sleep at the same time as before. And you want to set time limit for entertainment. So if you like to play computer games, if you want to play with your iPad, make sure that there's a reminder, say at 10:30, you have to stop at this point. So you still go to bed online. You need to be very self-disciplined in managing your time. And third, be an active learner. Do not wait for the professor's reminder. After you read the syllabus, you're going to have a planner, you're going to have a schedule. Suppose you're taking 3 classes, accounting, chemistry, and economics. And suppose it's week 9. You are going to go to the 3 syllabus and ask yourself, what do I have to do this week in week 9? What do I have to do for accounting? What do I have to do for chemistry? And so on. And if before the transition, you had your accounting class on Tuesday, Thursday morning, and chemistry on Tuesday, Thursday afternoon, economics on Monday, Wednesday afternoon, I want you to keep that steady schedule even when you're studying at home. So if today is Tuesday morning, then you're going to say, oh, it's accounting time. In week 9, I'm supposed to do this and this and this for accounting. And do this for your every class. So be an active learner. 4, you want to review on Friday afternoon. So typically, I know face-to-face class have very few class scheduled on Friday afternoon. So when the classes are on time, Friday afternoon is a good time for you to review. Have I done what I'm supposed to do for week 9 for all the classes I'm taking? Suppose I didn't do accounting very well, then Friday afternoon is a good time for me to review accounting for whatever I have not studied. So review. Last but not least, if after you read through your syllabus, you check all the professor's email and announcements, and you did your reading, you watch your video, you still have questions, please don't hesitate to talk to your professor, because professors are more than willing to help. But the prerequisite is that you have to do your part first. Because, for example, if the professor has made an announcement 3 times and you didn't read the announcement, you ask the professor the same question. Some professors are not going to take that question very kindly. Because remember, this is a trying time for you and for the professor as well. So please do your part and then talk to your professor. And unless your professor stated otherwise, you want to use your college or university email account to email the professor. Because we have a spam folder. So typically, if you're sending email from Gmail or Hotmail, it will be filtered and professor will never receive it. And also, according to FERPA regulations, professors are prohibited from discussing a student-related issue with you unless you send an email from your .edu account. So I hope these 5 smart steps will help you, and I wish you a very successful rest of the semester or quarter. God bless you. God bless everyone on this planet.